The fifth Agege Local Government Education Authority Human Capacity Development Training for the non-teaching staff was indeed an eye-opener for the participants in the area of ethical values and professional responsibilities. The Education Secretary, Local Government Education Authority in Agege, Honorable Olaleko Madiagbe, in his welcome address urged the participants to make good use of the opportunity this seminar has to offer.
Regarding today's serious business of renewing our ethical values, our future responding as a public servant occupies sensitive positions, either as clerical officers, cleaners, office assistants, and watchmen in our public school and local government education authority. Because nobody is useless. You are an important person in the school. We are not here for ceremony, we are here to learn. A lot of you knew very well what happened in academic environment. You must be writing. You must be jotting something down.
Reverend Dr. Veros from the Chapel of Christ the Light Church, Alausa, and representative of the Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Education, Mrs. Oshikoya, charged the participants on the need to put into practice everything learned at the seminar.
All of you have been part of that move to work on the performance level of the sector where you belong. And today that you are back here to be informed of what has to be done is to show that where we have things that are working, we must still work to improve them. And as you have come here today, I would desire that your coming will improve your commitment to service delivery.
In your area, in your office,
please make sure you are doing things as expected. I implore you to please do your work diligently. And as you do it, God in heaven will reward you accordingly in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray that our work will be rewarded on this earth, not in heaven. But even when we get to heaven, God will still reward us for the good work.
The guest speaker, Mr. Jide Ologun, did a good job of analyzing the theme, ethical values and professional responsibility for effective service delivery.
You need to understand the place you work so that you can enjoy that place and add value when you are there. Employers value employees who come to work on time, are there when they are supposed to be, and are responsible for their actions and behavior. Are you hardly working or hard working? Some people are hardly working. Like the Honorable said, they come to work, they sit down, they listen to all the good music, they eat all their malaram, they do all the gossiping, but there is no result to produce. That is a very, very unproductive life. We need to be hardworking to check, make a change. If you don't like your job, please don't continue in that job. Go and find something else to do. Because you have the capacity to produce results. So if you are not productive where you are, relocate. If you cannot find another job, start a job. Start a business. And I have told myself, wherever I get to in life, I must be a contributor to solution, not amplifier of problems. Some of us are amplifiers of problems. You know all the problems, but what solution have you brought to these problems? You must be able to manage your life in the direction of joy.
Other dignitaries present also took turns in encouraging and enlightening the participants.
As a staff of this AGE, you should try to be responsible in whatever you are doing. Moral attitude is also very important. Then, coming to school, please, you should be very, very punctual.
You must be able to give account of whatever has been entrusted in your hands. Decency in speech and dressing, decency, is the watchword that we must keep. You must not use them while languages as a educators. It doesn't matter you are a clerk, or you are a cleaner, or you are a guard. You are working within the education sector. So you must be very decent in your speech. In your dressing, you must be decent.
A clerical officer is as a professional responsibility, which includes conduct general office task. That is to say, you are directly responsible to the head teacher. Directly responsible to the head teacher and have many tasks to perform.
Refusal to accept a posting or transfer to a unit is a misconduct. Then habitual lateness to work, which is very common, is a very misconduct. Deliberate delay in treating official documents, maybe in an information being sent to your school, instead of you to give to your teacher on time, you are keeping it the next morning and the next day. It's a deliberate keeping an official document, which can also lead to termination, withdrawal, deferment, or suspension of the service. Because that information being sent to you, they are as important as any other thing. Then again, sleeping on duty.
Nigeria is one of the countries that adopted and signed the law of this child rights. Now, we see these children as our own, but they also have some rights and privileges they too must enjoy in life. We know that they are our children, but they also have some things that they should know and some things that we as parents, guardians, or elders around them must also know. Know and respect their own rights as well.
Conclusively, to whom much is given, much is expected. It is hoped that the participants at the 5th Agege LGA Human Capacity Development Seminar will put into practice every knowledge gained, thereby ensuring effective service delivery in the discharge of their duties. Hereby notified that registration of children for admission into Nursery 1, Primary 1 in September 2014 will commence in all the divisions of Lagos State from Tuesday, the 27th of May 2014. The minimum registration age for Primary 1 is 6 years, while the minimum registration age into Nursery 1 is 3 years. Application forms for registration can be obtained from the head teachers of all public nursery and primary schools in Lagos State. Parents and guardians should register in the schools nearest their homes. Completed application forms must be accompanied by 3 passport size photographs of the child and the child's birth certificate. To the head teachers of the schools from where the forms were obtained, parents are advised to register at only one center. Registration is free. Affected children must be brought along to the registration center. For more information, please call 080-2466-1427 or 081-5068-0934 or visit the nearest public primary school in the state. Announcer, Mrs. Bolawan Daudu, the Executive Chairman, State Universal Basic Education Board.
Please, parents, guardians, don't hesitate and don't debar any child. They must not be used for child labor. Take them out to any center of your choice nearest your home and make sure that these children are registered. It is free and it is compulsory.
This is to inform all head teachers and principals of public primary and secondary schools in Lagos State to kindly activate the recently issued official email address by following these steps. 1. Visit www.lagosschoolsonline.com. 2. Click on the log on to the webmail tab. 3. Enter your full email address. 4. Enter your issued password. 5. Change your issued password to enhance the security of your email address. For further inquiries, please call 080 0823322771 or 0818760 9231. Announcer, the Lagos State Ministry of Education.